In the last video, we discussed about the Arima model. In this video, we are going to discuss how to find the order of differencing in Arima model. The purpose of differencing is to make the time series stationary, but you need to be careful to not over-difference the series because the over-differenced series may still be stationary, which in turn will affect the model parameters. So how to determine the right order of differencing? The right order of differencing is the minimum differencing required to get a near stationary series which roams around a defined mean and the ACF plot reaches to zero fairly quick. If the autocorrelations are positive for many number of lags, 10 or more, then the series needs further differencing. On the other hand, if the lag 1 autocorrelation itself is too negative, then the series is probably over-differenced. In the event you can't really decide between two orders of differencing, then go with the order that gives the least standard deviation in differenced series. Let's see how to do with an example. First, I am going to check if the series is stationary using the augmented decay Fuller test from the stats model package, because you need differencing only if the series is non-stationary. Else, no differencing is needed, then that is D equal to 0. The null hypothesis of the ADF test is that the time series is non-stationary. So if the p-value of the test is less than the significance level 0.05, then you reject the null hypothesis and infer that the time series is indeed stationary. So in our cases, if p-value greater than 0.05, we go ahead with finding the order of differencing. Since p-value is greater than the significance level, let's difference the series and see how the autocorrelation plot looks like. This is the code I have written. Here you have the plot for the autocorrelation. For the above series, the time series reaches stationary with two orders of differencing. But on looking at the autocorrelation plot, for the second differencing, the lag goes into the far negative zone fairly quick, which indicates the series might have been over-differenced. So I am going to tentatively fix the order of differencing as 1, even though the series is not perfectly stationary. Now, finding the order of the AR term, how to find the P order of the AR term. The next step is to identify if the model needs any AR terms. You can find out the required number of AR terms by inspecting the partial autocorrelation plot. What is this PACF, partial autocorrelation plot? See, partial autocorrelation can be imagined as the correlation between the series and its lag. After excluding the contributions from the intermediate lags, so PACF sort of conveys the pure correlation between a lag and the series. That way, you will know if the lag is needed in the AR term or not. So what is the formula for PACF mathematically? Partial autocorrelation of lag k of a series is the coefficient of that lag in the autoregression equation of y. So this is the equation. If yt is the current series and yt minus 1 is the lag 1 of y, then the partial autocorrelation of lag 3, that is yt minus 3, is the coefficient alpha 3 of yt minus 3 in the equation. Now, how to find the number of AR terms? Any autocorrelation in a stationarized series can be rectified by adding enough AR terms. So we initially take the order of AR term to be equal to as many lags that crosses the significance limit in the PACF plot. You can observe that the PACF lag 1 is quite significant since is well above the significance line. Lag 2 turns out to be significant as well, slightly managing to cross the significance limit. But I'm going to be conservative and tentatively fix the P as 1. Now, how to find the order of MA term, that is the Q? Just like how we looked at the PACF plot for the number of AR terms, you can look at the ACF plot for the number of MA terms. And MA term is technically the error of the lagged forecast. The ACF tells how many MA terms are required to remove any autocorrelation in the stationarized series. Let's see the autocorrelation plot of the differenced series. Couple of lags are well above the significance line, so let's tentatively fix Q as 2. When in doubt, go with a simpler model that sufficiently explains the why. See, now one more point is how to handle if a time series is slightly under or over differenced. It may so happen that your series is slightly under differenced. That differencing it one more time make it slightly over differenced. How to handle this case? If your series is slightly under differenced, adding one or more additional AR terms usually makes it up. Likewise, it is slightly over differenced, try adding an additional MA term.